The Gerudo lived in a settlement in the Gerudo Desert. Comprised entirely of women, they were a tribe of great might and nobility. For her exceptional strength and her ability to harness lightning, Urbosa, chief of the Gerudo, was the clear choice to pilot divine beast Va Naboris. Zelda knew Urbosa thanks to her close relationship with the late Queen of Hyrule. With her party in tow, Zelda traveled to Gerudo Town to speak with her old friend. However, their journey took an unexpected turn.
Hey! Urbosa! Why? What are you doing?
Thwarting your destiny, of course. Princess Zelda. I came back as quickly as I could. Not exactly what I expected to find.
Urbosa?
I hope you're not hurt, little bird.
I'm not.
You've got some nerve, thinking you can go toe-to-toe with Master Koga! I'll show you! Yiga, assemble! Me excluded, of course.
What?
Jump!
Fine, fine.
Take it! My way!
Easily done.
out.
How could these losers defeat me?
Hmm? Master Koga.
Suga, you're late! I nearly got peeled like a banana! Oh!
Forget these cowards. It's time to retreat.
I think not!
Thank you for meeting me here. The town is a bit, chaotic, shall we say.
Of course, Urbosa. We'd meet you anywhere.
You know about the Yiga clan, I trust. Sheikah traitors working in the shadows to revive Calamity Ganon. Those lowlifes have been wreaking havoc here in Gerudo Canyon. How long can we stand by and watch them get away with it? No longer, I say. I will pilot this divine beast. You are precious to me, and you need my help. I cannot refuse.
Thank you, Urbosa. As Princess of Hyrule, I too will carry out my sworn duty.
Little bird. However I am able to support you, I will. Just say the word.
So, you turned and fled. Is that it?
Well, if they hadn't interrupted me...
It seems that, as low as my expectations of you were, I was overly optimistic.
What?
Well, no matter. My harbinger. Show me the future. Yes. The future, as it will and must be, I will not allow anyone to alter its course.